Good morning, children. Welcome back to today's class. So yesterday we have learned about the time, about the speedometers and units of time. Like 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute and 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour, 24 hours is equal to 1 day. In this way we have learned and the duration of the time for the prayer and for the ringing of the school bell and about the stop clock, how when it is used. And I also asked you to check your health regarding corona. So in this way we have learned about the time and everything. Now it's time to learn about the units of speed. Depending on the need and the context, speed is measured in different units. Unit of speed in SI system is meter per second. Meter per second, m by s is equal to meter per second. So this is all the formulas that you have to keep it in your mind. And one more instruction, children, for you. If you are not understood, you can ask me again, but please listen the video once and twice, because I am explaining with examples. And when some of you have not understood the to and fro motion, it's very easy if you observe the pendulum, but you are not at all taking care. So please listen the video once and twice, then it will be understood for you. Now unit of speed in SI system is calculated in this way, meters per second. Now other unit commonly used for the speed is kilometer per hour. This is also very important, kilometer per hour. So 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. This is the unit. 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Do you know how do we got this? We'll see. One kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meter per second. So 1 kilometer is equal to, we have to convert into meters. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. And 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So when you are changing kilometers into meter, we have to change the hours into seconds. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters, 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 1000 meters by 3600 seconds. When you do with two table, you will get the 5 by 18. Meters per second. This is the meter and this is the second. That's why we are writing 5 by 18 meters per second. So in this way we have got this calculation. Once again, go through the textbook and again the video. It's very easy. It's not a big calculation. Just with two table we have done this one. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. When we are changing kilometers into meter, we have to change the hours into seconds. So in this way we got the 5 by 18 meters per second. This is the speed of in kilometers per hour. So 1 kilometer per 1 hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Now consider a car is driven on a road. A person seated behind the driver recorded the distance traveled for every 10 minutes by noting the distance regarding the odometer. The distance traveled by the car at different instances of time is as follows. So here they have given the time and regarding distance covered. For every 10 minutes he has calculated the time. Now how do you find the speed of the car? Is the speed of the car uniform throughout the journey? From the table we notice that the car has covered unequal distance in equal time. So for every 10 seconds it is not traveled the same distance. For 10 minutes 15 kilometers, then 20 minutes it will be 30 kilometers. But here 25 kilometers is given. So that means it has traveled unequal distance. And which shows the speed of the car is not uniform. So the speed of the car is not uniform. To find the speed of the car in the journey, we should calculate the total distance traveled by a car and the total time taken to cover the distance. Now, what is the total distance here? He has traveled 15 plus 25 plus 38 plus 60 we have to do. And the time taken 10, 20, 30, 40. So, overall we have to calculate it. The distance must be either in meters or kilometers and time in seconds or hours. We express the speed either in meters per second or kilometers per hour. Already I have told, now we can express the time in meters per second or kilometers per hour. Now 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and 40 minutes is equal to 40 by 60 we have to do. Now 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes when 40 minutes is equal to 40 by 60, that is equal to 2 by 3 hours. So speed is equal to distance traveled by time taken, total time taken and total distance traveled, that is equal to 60 by 2 by 3, that is equal to 60 into 3 by 2 kilometers per hour, that is equal to 90 kilometers per hour. Thus the car traveled with an average speed of 90 kilometers per hour. So how do we got this? Total distance traveled by a car is equal to 60 kilometers. So example they have given, and the total time taken is equal to 40 minutes. So for 1 hour it will be 60 minutes, and the 40 minutes is equal to 40 by 60. Then we will get 2 by 3 hours. Now speed is equal to distance, total distance traveled and total time taken. So total distance traveled is equal to 60 and time taken is equal to 2 by 3 hours. So when it comes here, 60 into 3 by 2 kilometers per hour, then we will get the 90 kilometers per hour. So, in this way, we can calculate the speed of the car is equal to 90 kilometers per hour. Now, one more problem they have given. Solve the following problem. They have given the speed of the bus is 72 kilometers per hour, whereas speed of the car is 12.5 meters per second. Which vehicle moves faster? They have given the speed of the two vehicles, but one is expressed in kilometers per hour and another is expressed in meters per second. So the two calculations are different. This to compare the speeds, the time must be converted into same units. The speed of the bus is, speed of a bus is equal to 72 kilometers per hour. Now speed of the car is equal to, speed of a car is equal to 12.5 meters per second. Now what we have to do, we have to convert this into kilometers per hour. Now 1 kilometer per hour we have studied that it is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Now 1 meter per second is equal to 18 by 5 kilometers per second. So 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Now 1 meter per second is equal to 18 by 5 kilometers per second. Thus the speed of the car we have to calculate 12.5 into 18 by 5, that is equal to 45 kilometers per hour. First we have to change it into kilometers per hour. Here they have given meters per second. Now this we have converted into kilometers per hour. 1 kilometer per 1 hour is equal to 5 by 18 meter per second. Now when we want to calculate for only 1 meter per seconds is equal to 18 by 5 kilometers per second. Now we have to do 12.5 meters per second into 18 by 5 kilometers per second, then 45 kilometers per 1 hour will be the answer. Now we have changed the speed of the car. The speed of the car we have changed it into 45 kilometers per second. 45 kilometers per hour. Sorry. So now speed of the bus is 72 kilometers per hour. Speed of the car is equal to 45 kilometers per hour. Now which vehicle moves faster? Obviously the bus moves faster. So to know that, first this we have to convert into kilometers per hour, or this one into meters per second. It both should be in the same units. Then you can calculate the speed. So by this we have finished the chapter. Now once again go through the. If you are having workbook, go through the question answers, and you have to do 2-3 problems in this way. Then you'll be understood. So this is a very important chapter, children. We have learned so many main points in this chapter about the motion and rotatory motion, translatory motion, oscillatory motion, and about the electrical clocks, digital clocks, and in previous times they used to use the sand clocks, and about the speedometers, odometers, and the units of the speed in meters per second. Speed of the unit in SI system is meters per second. In this way we have learned very many important points in this chapter. So once again go through the lesson, and your homework is write the keywords that are given in the back of the lesson. In this chapter they have given the keywords, all the keywords you have to write it in the notebook very neatly and learn the hard words as well as go through the lesson. Thank you.